flexi, come chica, dando quella vuelta, pica, pica. Estoy usando una varita, mientras todo dinamita. Estoy flexi, come chica, dando quella vuelta, pica, pica. Estoy usando una varita, mientras todo dinamita. Más de más de lo de respeto, quemo, quemo, subo al cielo. Pero arriba, arriba no me encuentro más nuevo. Y luego acabo con titulado suelos. Quería subir par. Cara de grabar track. Soltarse las barras poco más. Sin imaginar lo que podría pasar. Siempre sonrío, río con los cerrados. Bebo partido el hilo en la escalera sentado. Hermano, ¿por qué andas preocupado? Pensando en las cosas te han pasado. ¿Qué pasó, mi pana? Estoy matando con la hawaiana. Volando sin posición, raras. El peso de mi alma y alma tan sana. Fondo flexi, chica. Dando vueltas, pica. Estoy usando la varita. Mientras yo soy una mina. Fondo flexi, chica. Dando vueltas, pica. Estoy usando la varita. Mientras todo dinamita. Los sueños se derriten por aquí. Esa es así. Veo la vida como la talilla. Soy quien soy. Yo no pienso huir. Aunque tenga que irme al ring. Aunque es el significado del amor en Google. Tú dime que me quieres. Quiero pero no lo deseo. Sigo como yo sigo mi nube. Regando las plantas empezando el lunes. Mi vida es una jam. Yo no trazo un plan. Lo que tengo que venir. Vendrá, yo soy la tierra. Tú solo pasas por cebra. ¿A qué esperas? Abre una ventana nueva. Súbete donde están dejadas las valentenas. Respira bien, puedes ser quien quieras. Escúchate por dentro, a ver qué suena.
Hello, how is everyone? Hello, who we got? Solar Hawk. How are you, sir? How are you? I was in your neighborhood yesterday. We were in Bath. And then the missus decided she wanted to go and have a look at what Bristol was all about. So we did a real quick route into Bristol, and wasn't much to report. Yeah, I was hoping that apparently the balloon festival, it was supposed to be happening, but I didn't see a balloon, didn't even see a party balloon. But yeah, that would have been a nice sight. To see the balloon festival. Maybe I was in the wrong area, I don't know, but there were signs all on the motorway talking about the hot air balloon festival. So we are, where are we? We are in Nice. What? It's me live. Hello, sir. Hello, hello, hello. How are you? Just back from a very short weekend trip down to Bath. First time I've been down to Bath. Probably the last time I'm going to be in Bath, to be fair. Not much happening in Bath. Very touristic. A bit dirty. And yeah, quite a few people over there do need a bath, I think. Yeah, but yeah. I suppose if you haven't done it, you know what? I mean, if you don't live so far away, do a day trip. I wouldn't spend a night there. Not at all. From where I am, it's about an hour and a half drive. I should have done that. I should have gone. Nah, London's good, man. London's popping, man. London's good. Yeah, but Bath. Yeah, I mean, you know, an hour and a half to get into Bath, and then spend, you know, 6-7 hours looking around, and then straight back. You know, that's more like my thing. I think I'm gonna do Wales next time. I'm thinking I want to do the Mac Loop. Take a tent and go and sit on top of a mountain and watch fighter jets fly by me, but fly below me, you know. Yeah, that I think is more my style. Cool. So we are at Nice, we are, and we're going to be flying over to Athens. This is Nice. This is the Microsoft Asobo implementation of Nice. Not bad, actually. Not bad. I quite like it. Yeah, not bad at all. And we are going to head on over to Athens. That's where we're going. We're going to Athens. The Fly Tampa. Fly Tampa, scenery of Athens. We're in the Air France livery today in the Phoenix. I haven't flown the Phoenix for a while, so yeah, why not? All right. Sally Circle. One day, Sally said to Jock, "There's a hole in. You aren't going to get it mended." Oh wow. Solar Hawk, really? okay, let's have a look at our route today. There's our route. Okay. So we're going to take off from Nice and fly across Italy and then down into Greece. All right. So let's just check. What sort of weather do we have? We don't have much weather at the moment. Although England, we're going to get some lovely rain coming in very soon. I've been looking forward to that. But yeah, only a little bit of weather over Lazio, Italy, a bit. But pretty much clear all the way. Oh dear. God, it's not even 2 o'clock yet. It's not even 2 o'clock yet. All right, let's jump into the cockpit, get this thing going. All right. Oop, no, I don't want to go there. I want to go here. There we are. Okay, let's start things up with my fingerprint. There we go. And let's bring in the flight plan from Simbrief. There we are. And we got 27 minutes till departure. We are good. So let's just start our mass and balance while we're doing this. So load aircraft, we'll go fast time. There we are, and boarding has started. Do we have we don't have the jetway yet, do we? Let's see if we can pull the jetway. Ground services, toggle jetway, there we are. Okay. Nice and balance going on. All right, let's power this puppy on. There we are. There we are. External power is available. Arm, crew supply, nav one. Nav two. And nav three. There we go. They can go on and auto. Yeah, okay. And fuel is being loaded, so we'll do the seatbelts later on. Okay, let's drop down here. So Atsu, AOC menu, flight initialization. There we go, and call in the flight plan. There we are, Air France 321, Nice to Athens. Estimated time on route is 2 hours, just over 2 hours. Okay, there we are. So in it. Okay, init request, let's pull that in. Alright, that is good. What is our cost index today? Let's have a look. Cost index of 34. We've got a flight level of 37,000. There we are. Our flight number is Air France 3, 2, and 1. There we are. And wind, let's request the wind. Are you guys not flying? You're most welcome to jump on if you want and join me at Nice to Athens. There we are. All of that is good. The route is in the chat, exclamation mark route. I'm on the North Europe server, as always. There we are. Init B page we will do later on. Okay, our departure is what is our departure? Let's just pop it in there for my, there we are. Okay, four right. And we're expecting the SOD 7 Alpha. SOD 7 Alpha. And we can insert that. And then we can go to our arrival is 21 left. And we're going Zulu 21 left. Yankee. Zulu 21 left. We are Neem 1 Alpha, and our VR is going to be EGN. There we are, and insert. Okay, let's just check our flight plan while we're there. Any discos? Nope, no discos. Very nice. Okay, let's just pop all that in there as well. So 37. There we are. And let's pop this on. What is our Q&H today? Let's have a look. One zero one one zero zero seven. There we are. Constraints on, and we are good. There we are. Okay, how are we getting on with our loading of passengers? 96 boarded. Fuel is already done, and cargo is done. So we're just waiting for passengers. Okay. And the IR ideas will line up in 5 minutes. Okay, in the meantime, what can we do? There is now we can do. We need the init, we need the performance. So let's wait for the load sheet. And yeah, so this is the Air France, with apparently the Air France cabin already done as well, which is, I guess, this thing here. But yeah, and it will light up during the night. So, we just wait for the init, the mass to be done, and then we can proceed to the init B page. In the meantime, let's just hop outside and have a look at the airport. Why not? So this is the Sobo's implementation of the airport. It's not bad. I think who did Nice? I think it was Just Sim or Just Flight, one of those Justs. And yeah, it's all right. It's not so bad. Is that the fire station there? I take it this is the fire station. But yeah, it looks okay. It looks good. I don't know if they've modeled anything. I don't think so. Oh no, they have. Cool. So you can't sort of go in, but you can see. Yeah. Oh well. Okay, let's see how we're doing on the on the loading of the passengers there. All right. We are boarded. Dismiss. Okay. Let's go to our init page. There we are. Init B. What have we got? We've got 58.8311. 58.8588311. 588311. 588311. Okay, there we are. And the fuel was 9.1. There we are. The deers should be aligned already. Are they? Oh, 1 minute. 1 minute for alignment. And they're aligned. And this should populate. He says. One minute to alignment. There we go. And that is populated. Okay, next. Okay, next we got our performance. There we are, and takeoff. Okay, sync load sheet. There we are. We are leaving on 4 right. Sync live weather. Optimum. There we go. Pack can go on. That's all good. Calculate. Okay, 139146. 139146. 146. One down. Down 0.1. One down 0.1. Okay, flex temp was 56, was it? Yes, it was 56. And we got noise abatement 10 10, and 10 10. And there we are. Transition is 5,000. Yes, it is. There we are. We are good. Okay. All of that is good. Flight plan is done. Performance initialized. Yep. There we are. We are good. Okay. Let's start the APU. 1, 2. On. There we are. And we can go back to ground services. And do we have any messages? We do not have any company messages yet. And even if we do, I don't care. They annoy me. So flight plan. And let's go here and performance page there. Okay. And there is a company message. Oh. Atsu AOC menu. Receive messages. There, accept, return. And let's go back to flight plan. There we are. Okay. APU should be on. Come on. Available. There we are. And APU bleed is on. Let's pop on the fuel pumps. And we are going to be taxiing with nose going left. Okay. There we are. That's good. APU bleed is on. We can go beacon on. And let's get rid of the GPU. So there, off. Okay. So GPU disconnect and chocks in there, disconnect. And let's connect the tug and push back. So we want to push back and nose going, tail going that way, nose going that way, nose going left. Okay, let's do this. Parking brake is released and start. There we are. In the meantime, let's get the old engine started. Engine 2. Uni 301, thank you, sir. Thank you for the follow. Well, we are just about to head on to Athens. We're leaving Nice, which is the Asobo handcrafted Nice. So we want to go nose left. Hey, Gordo, mate. Hello, sir. Wondered where you are. I wondered when you were going to show up. How you doing, sir? Okay, let's go nose left. Alright. And let's go to engine 2 and let's see how we do here. There's the dog barking. Oh. Okay, let's see this. Almost. There we are. We can stop. Backwards and stop. And the tug is probably scarpered so fast. Okay, parking brake on. We can go. Engines, are they coming on? They are. We can go flaps 1 and we can arm the ground spoilers, brakes max. There we are. TCAS can go. Old Man Shaggy just sent a PM. Oh wow, that's a shame. Wow, sorry about that. Yeah, for those who don't know, so Old Man Shaggy, he has a few cats. And his cat today got, or yesterday I think, got hit by a car and passed away. That's a shame. Okay, so APU bleed. Engines are started. Let's go. APU bleed off and APU off. There we go, we are ready. Taxi lights on, runway lights on, seat belts on, and on. There we are. Stug, hello sir, how are you? Okay, let's taxi. Oh, I tell you, I don't know about this. The frames are a bit shitty again. Don't know what's going on with Microsoft anymore. But yeah, it is what it is. Chrono, there we are. And let's start our taxi. Parking brake off. TCAS. I forgot TCAS. TCAS. There we are, and there we are. Yeah, I agree, mate. Okay, let's do this. The fly-by-wire is free. The fly-by-wire is completely free. This is 50 quid. I've been flying the fly-by-wire as well. Is it worth the money? Oh, that's such a tough question, isn't it? In the state it is at the moment, I think they still got a ways to go. That's my honest opinion. I think if you want to spend money, buy the PMDG 737. I'm sure there are people in the chat that will agree with me. But yeah, buy the 737. Okay, there we are. There she is. So we're going to taxi right to the end. We did get the Grayson. Yes, we did. We did get the company message, and I did attend to it. I haven't seen another one. But you know what? We don't need no stinking company messages. I didn't pay 50 quid for company messages. Alright. But every company message that I don't clear, they should refund me a pound. Okay, we're going to go right to the end. We're going to cross 4 left and head on to 4 right. I am doing okay. I'm doing well. I hope you're doing well too. So this is, we are at Nice, Asobo's Nice, and we're heading to Fly Tampa's Athens. I'm quite liking the Nice implementation. It's quite nice. I think it was Just Flight or Just Sim that had Nice before. And oh, I just ran over some birds, I think. There we go. I'm running over birds and they're still alive. There we go. Let's pop on some strobes as we are getting there. There we are. And pop that on there. They stutter at crucial time, don't they? They stutter or they sell their tanks, don't they? Oh, I stream quite a, I mean, I try and at least get 3 streams in a week. Sometimes life gets in the way, like everything. But yeah, I try. A lot of my crew are in the chat. Our small community, all flight simmers, flight streamers. I'll give them shout outs in a bit, but Dryson, Gordo, Old Man Shaggy, Solar Hawk, they're all flight simmers and very knowledgeable. You know, if you have any problems or any issues with the sim, yeah, we can all help as well. Oh yeah, sorry, and Snare.
Enough is enough! I have had it with these motherfucking snakes on this motherfucking plane! Everybody strap in!
So Snare is building an airport right now, so he's doing a new scenery for Microsoft Flight Sim. And we've got Batman, who's also a very regular visitor to the stream and flies a lot, streams occasionally, but the whole crew is turning up. They're all waking up. Okay, we're on 4 right. Okay, let's line up and wait. Just do one little scan and then we can take off. There we go. All right, one scan. Parking brakes are being brake, toe brakes are held. Everything here looks good. There we are, and upstairs. Yep, all looks good. All right, let's go. Oh, DCS is nice. I do like DCS, but it's a really steep learning curve. Okay, here we go. Okay, RPMs, thrust up 40%, 50%. There we are. And we are going to flex. There we are, man flex SRS. There we are. Good. Okay, 100 knots. And rotate. Oh, and Captain Custard is here as well. Nice. There we go. Positive rate. Gear up. And Captain Custard. There he is. Oh, and Stug. Yeah, he's also a good big flight simmer. Oh, and let's turn towards our, there we are, lever climb. There we go, and heading out. How's it, bruh? I'm okay. There we are. Just got back from Bath. Yeah, I'm not going back there in a hurry. Oh, what's going on with my, there we go. All right. Let's keep that track. There we go. Let's follow that cross. Oh, Follow that cross. Follow that cross. There we are. And autopilot on. And let's go. There we are. Leaving. Ah, Dino, mate. Hello, sir. Hello, sir. How you doing, bro? You alright? There we go. Flaps can go up. There we go. Flaps coming up. And we are heading towards Athens. There we go. Spoilers disarmed. And everything is looking good. Loose, morning, sir. Morning, morning. I'm good, mate. How are you doing? How are you doing? I hope everyone is all right. Okay, here we go. Standard pressure. Standard pressure. So standard pressure, standard pressure. And it's going to alarm because I didn't do that one as well. There we go. All right. Yeah, yeah, yeah. But he'll be in bed soon. I'm imagining Dino lying in bed with a laptop. You know, watching me stream. Oh, they're terrible, terrible. Brilliant. You got no one to tuck you in. Brilliant. When you finish, how hard will it be? The F-18 is, I mean, when you install DCS, you get that free sort of, the thing that looks like a hawk, you get that for free, but the F-18 is a huge undertaking. I mean, it takes some time to learn to fly. Last time I heard someone trying to learn it, it took them 3 months. There we go, 10,000 feet. Landing lights can come off. There we are, taxi lights off. And there we go. Seat belts can also go off from signs to auto. Oh, that's right. Yeah. So, yeah, apparently that's what I heard. So you can get the, the DCS. Yeah, DCS one. I heard it's really, I mean, it's très compliqué. But I did, yeah, I heard that they give you free trial of all their aircraft for 2 weeks or something. Has he? No. Let me have a look. Oh, he has. There we go. There he is. Oh, he's doing a Nepal, it seems to be. Paro, Kathmandu. So, here we go. Hi. Look. There we go. He who shall not be named. Nomad Aviator. Nomad Aviator. He's doing a Paro to Delhi. Looks like he's taking off from Paro. He's not going into Paro. Okay. So we are heading towards Italy. Let's set that. There we go. There's our, so that's our top of climb right there, but that'll keep moving. It will keep on adjusting until it's sure.
2 start, press any key. Where's the any key? I see Esk, Kataro, and Piga. There doesn't seem to be any key.
I like this one. Where is it? Where is it? Where is it?
Do you think man will ever walk on the sun?
No. The sun is too hot. It is not a good place to go to.
What happens if they went in winter?
They all sound like it's got reverb on it, do they?
Somebody gonna get a hurt real bad.
Be a man. Do the right thing. Isn't that what he does? Russell Peters.
Hey! Be a man! Be a man! Do the right thing!
Do the right thing! I saw him live.
Woohoo! Look at that lover fly!
I saw him live when he was like just starting. Where I saw him in San Francisco, yeah. I saw him live. But after that, I think he just recycles, he reuses jokes. His first ever stand-up was good, was brilliant. After that, I could relate. But after that, nah. Didn't do it for me. Did you all see my my t-shirt that my sons bought me? Look at that. How cool is that? Oh, someone had to do a fart, didn't they? Hey? Here we are. We're all in. We're heading to cruise in cruise configuration. 19,000 feet. I'm just gonna send a comment to Nomad. Didn't have the bottle to fly into Paro. Here we go. So I just sent Nomad a comment on his thing. Didn't have the bottle to fly into Paro. Unless he did it earlier, I don't know. It is in an A380. I've seen people land 787s as well. I am really looking forward. I don't know if any of you saw the A380 video that came out yesterday, maybe from Fly By Wire. I am really looking forward to the A380. I think it looks so nice, and for it being free, I mean, wow. I think so. It's just going to be beautiful. It's going to be beautiful. It's going to be awesome. Although, did you pick up the spelling mistakes? side stick preparatory. Yeah. Apparently those are Easter eggs. And then you got those two INOP stickers on engines 3 and 4. The 717. Who's doing that? Who's doing the 717? Synaptic. What is Synaptic doing? Synaptic is doing the 200, right? The Airbus A320-200, are they? Or what are they doing? A220, sorry? Ah, right. Okay. A220. Yeah, that's what they're doing. Synaptic. The A350-1000, yeah, that should be nice. I think with the A380, Dubai is gonna get very, very busy. Especially on VATSIM, I think all the A380s with their Emirates liveries flying out. But the thing that's going to piss me off is when FlightSim.to has the Ryanair A380 or the EasyJet A380.
Here we go again.
Or the Coca-Cola livery for the A380. And that's where, you know, when I saw that with the Concorde, that sort of sealed it for me. I did not want to buy that Concorde. So we're coming up to our top of climb, not long away. There we are, about 40 nautical miles. We're at 28,000 feet. Where did I fly a few days ago, which had, oh, I don't remember. Exactly, yeah. Batman, yeah, and barrel roll on his way into the runway. That's right. His computer won't handle London City. So there we are. We are now hitting the top of Italy. Oh, sorry, Corsica. That is Corsica. This is where we are.
Hit my butt and call me butter ass.
So that's where we are currently. So the island of Corsica. So we will cross the northern part of Corsica and then head on down towards Rome. So we will be flying over the top of Rome. Oh, really? Can handle London City fine, right? Okay. And then we will cross down to the heel of Italy and then into Athens.
United we are, well it's time to go home.
we have the approach. So the approach coming into Athens, we will fly over the top of Athens and going via Aegean and straight into runway 21 right, 21 left. There we are. So that is our approach in. So that's gonna be a nice approach as well. But yeah, it's gonna look very nice.
Climb, climb now, climb, crossing, climb, climb, crossing, climb, 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 clear of conflict.
No issue with traffic here. Anyone is, who's flying? Anyone I know? No. No one there. I think old man Shaggy was flying, right? Where was he flying to? Where is he flying? He's going to the Canaries. Wow, that's a long old flight that is. Grand Canary.
Hey! Be a man! Be a man! Do the right thing!
There we go, 33,000 feet. 37,000 feet is what we're aiming for.
That's what she said.
So this is the internal cabin, which is part of this part of this livery as well. And these lights will change color during the night, I think. Let's have a look. Is it gonna mess up something? No. Oh, supposed to. There we go, 35,000 feet. It's like 60 something gig, right? 61, 65 gig DCS. I don't remember, but yeah. Oh really? 100, almost the same size as Microsoft Flight Sim. Wow. The weather has really changed as well. We just got out of the last day of the heat wave was yesterday. We had 32 degrees and now we've really dropped down. The clouds come in. And yeah, it's going to be thundering and rain soon enough. So looking forward to that. Here we are approaching our cruise, 37,000 feet, coming up for that. And Italy, the coast of Italy, straight ahead of us. Wow. What do they have in Egypt? Do they have like Deliveroo and Just Eat, or do they have their own local companies? Or what is it? Food Panda or something? Talabat. Ah, never heard of that. We got so many now in the UK. Just Eat, Deliveroo, Uber Eats, Gorilla. So many. And to be honest, I never use any of them. I'd rather go and just get my food myself. By the time it arrives, it's just... either they've got the order wrong, or the bloke's eating half a sandwich, I don't know. Or it's cold. And I mean, no, I don't, yeah, not for me. I call up the restaurant, they know who I am, I go and get it, and then that's it, done. I don't want anyone in between my food chain. Call me old fashioned day. There we are. Why, you just jump on your bicycle and go and get it? If you're in Cairo, I mean, the traffic is mad anyway, isn't it? Traffic in Cairo is mad. But man cannot live on McDonald's alone. Oh, I think I need a coffee. I'm gonna go and get a coffee. I'll be back in 3 minutes. In the meantime, sit back, relax, stay tuned. I'll be back in 3 minutes. There we are, I'm back. A little sandwich as well, a little cheese sandwich. Here we are. So there is Rome Airport. Right there. Which I have from, who is that? MK Studios. Almost forgot how to start it up. It's just one button, isn't it? Well, that was a nice sandwich. Although, I'm sure Gordo makes some really good sandwiches. Well, at his store. I've started to enjoy Hovis seeded sensation. That is the only bread now we will have in the house. Very nice. Oh, lovely cup of coffee. He just posted a sandwich on Discord. Where? Oh, food. Wow. Is that like turkey, is it? That's a lot of turkey. What'd you call that sandwich then? Or is that roast chicken? I don't think it's ham. It's not pink enough for ham. That's a decent sandwich, that is. Yeah, turkey. Yep. Yeah. I mean, that's like a whole box of sliced turkey, isn't it? I mean, that's just ridiculous. A nice seeded bread, it seems, with a bit of poppy seed in it, maybe. I don't know. It looks like a bit of poppy seeds in there. Yep, that I could enjoy with some melted cheese in between, you know. Ooh. Oh, Jewish rye. So would you use the same bread for a Reuben, right? The kosher restaurants that I go to, they have like this Reuben, which is like, wow. We've got quite a few Jewish kosher restaurants. Yeah, I do enjoy a Jewish deli. So, oh, there was Rome. Now we're heading diagonally down Italy. A 4,000. I don't think. All depends on the price, eh, Dino? All depends on the price. I mean, what's the 30, the 3000 series out now? So you got the 3090 is still around, I mean, still over £1,000. Still over £1,000. I mean, you can get a 3060 or things like that for about maybe £500. But what about the AMD stuff? The AMD stuff is not bad. Apparently they are giving Nvidia a lot of trouble. I think, who is it? MSEP. MSEP has an AMD 6.9 something, I think. Very nice. What's the RAM on the 4000 or on the 4070? Are they going to be like 32 gig RAM now? I wish they would just come up with a video card that just had slots on it, and then you just buy how much RAM you want to buy and slot it in. So have the video card, have slots available on the card, and then you can order how much RAM you want. Well, of course, there'll be a maximum, I'm sure, but, you know, order RAM modules and slot them onto the video card. How hard can that be? But no, they want to just grab us and keep hold of us by our short curlies and, you know, there is no way of upgrading your video card without buying another video card. Surely if you had two slots or three slots on your video card and they had sticks available in configurations of 8 gig or 12 gig, 16 gig, and buy two 16 gig sticks, shove them in two slots, and there you go, 32 gig RAM, voila. But no, they don't want to do that. Someone needs to think out of the box and do it. Now, I'm pretty sure as soon as someone does it, then Nvidia and AMD will then jump on that bandwagon. So maybe there's a way to do it without actually making it, but just create the perception that it exists and force NVIDIA and AMD to do it. You know, create a bunch of YouTube videos pretending that's what you're doing, shove it in your machine, bang! It's all about perception. So I've been playing around with my car. I have a BMW, and I got one of those OBD adapters, and I'm able to go into the car now and activate a load of stuff in that car that if you didn't order it, you wouldn't have got it. And yeah, I've been having some good fun with that, activating stuff that you think they should have that already on the car as standard, but no, apparently you gotta pay for it. So you can go in to the ECU on the car and start activating the stuff. So that was some good fun. Like Apple CarPlay. If you want it, you got to pay for it. But there is a thing that's, you know, you go into it and then it just says Apple CarPlay, not active. Yeah? And then you hit active and all of a sudden Apple CarPlay comes on your head unit on the screen. Which would be useful if I had an Apple. Yeah? I don't. I use Android. ECU, your electronic control unit, the thing that the brains of the car. You can change, I can change the way my car reacts to my sports mode without traction control, things like that. Yeah, I've seen those as well. Yeah, I've got a couple of friends that do that as well. They can change the chip, but they don't even have to do that now. They just reprogram the chip to do something else. Snare, you either have an Apple or you have an Android. What would you have? Have you got an old Nokia candy phone, have you? Running Symbian OS. Your phone has to be in today's climate, your phone is either or. Yeah, I used to work for Symbian, man. I used to develop for Symbian. Shit, I even developed Windows Mobile. Can you imagine that? Yeah. I mean, I'm a software developer, right? But I'm focused on telecom. So these days, this is what I work on. So I write the OS for smart card. Yeah, so that's what I do. So Java card, things like that. Yeah, so all my test cards and everything. So when I send them out to customers. Yeah, I used to. So I mean, today I write, I do a lot of stuff with algorithms for telecom, for banking. But in the past, I used to work, I used to do stuff for Nokia, Symbian, Windows Mobile. So which one did I have? Where's my Windows Mobile? So the last one I worked on. So this was a Windows Mobile phone, right? Here's an archive, okay? It was called HTC. Do you remember HTC? Yeah. And you used to, and I like the form factor. The form factor isn't bad. You did that. Yeah. And then you could tilt it. And that was a Windows Mobile smartphone. Yeah, so I used to do a lot of work for HTC vis-a-vis Windows. But yeah, that I still have in work. It's working condition. It's still even got the pen in there, man. Still even has the pen. And then... Best phone I ever, exactly, the best phone I ever owned. You can't beat that Nokia. The best phone, without a doubt. Do you remember that? There we are. Look at that. Classic Nokia. I still use it when I go retro. I still use it. I have a whole box full of phones from Ericsson, from Sony Ericsson. I have the Nokia communicator, things like that. And it was funny because people, I can't find them. So yeah, I still have BlackBerry and stuff like that. But sometimes I go real old school and I take my SIM. Well, I take a SIM because I have many SIMs. I put it into one of these candy phones and I walk around having conversations and people go, whoa, you know. We sent you a WhatsApp message. And I said, my phone doesn't support WhatsApp. You know? I mean, I started in telecom back in the 80s. Yeah, I was there before we even knew what SMS was, man. And then I remember when we first sent the very first SMS we ever sent, and we went, wow, that's incredible. How did they do that? You know? And then I think I developed my first SIM card. I worked with a very large company. And we supplied our very first SIM card to Batelco Bahrain. And that was the very first customer we had. As a SIM customer was Batelco Bahrain. I remember I flew to Bahrain, spent a month there, setting up the their switch to deal with all the authentication for the SIM card. Yeah, so that was great.
Good night, sweetheart. Well, it's time to go home.
Good night, Dino. It is his bedtime. It must be what? Oh, it's got to be past midnight now, I think. Yeah, 10 past midnight. You have a good one, mate. And I will catch you tomorrow, I guess. You take care, man. You have a good rest. I was actually looking for the last Nokia that I ever worked on, and that was the Nokia Lumia, which was the Windows mobile phone from Nokia. The first PC you ever used had Windows XP on it. Wow. The first PC I ever used had DOS. The first PC I ever had DOS. MS-DOS. And then this thing came along, which was Windows 3.0, which was on two floppy disks. And then they added network. I'm talking PC, the very first computer. The very first computer I ever used was a BBC Micro. The first ever computer I ever bought, which I still have, is the Sinclair Spectrum. I still have it in a box in the attic, complete with two joysticks, RAM expansion, the thermal printer, and an old school tape deck. And then I had an Amiga 500, which was an awesome machine, the Amiga. I love it. The Amiga was a brilliant thing. And I remember Windows 3.0. And then the next version was Windows 3.1, which added the network capability. So, wow, that was incredible. I used to have an NEC 286 laptop with an NEC 9A mobile phone. And then I used to go around all the cell sites. So I used to build mobile networks. So I used to go around the cell sites, plug it in, and do all the diagnostics on a 286 machine. And everyone thought my machine was so powerful. So powerful. And mind you, this was when I was working in Pakistan. I was working in Pakistan for a company called Motorola. Yeah. And I would sit in a hotel restaurant or something with a laptop open and no one knew what it was. You know, no one knew what it was. It was an NEC 286. And there was my laptop. It was my laptop, my mobile phone, and everyone was just so confused because we hadn't launched yet. We hadn't launched the mobile network yet. So it was probably the first experience people had ever had of a mobile phone. Then after Pakistan, I moved to Egypt and I worked for a company called Orascom, which was I was working with Motorola, and Orascom was our partner, and created another company called Mobineal. And Mobineal was another mobile operator that I built. I don't know, is Mobineal still around, Batman? Mobineal? Is it still called Mobineal? I don't know. What are the mobile operators in Egypt? Who are the mobile operators in Egypt today? Mobile operators Egypt. Ah, okay. So the company I used to work for is now called Orange. Yeah. So this now Orange. It was formerly Mobineal. So, yeah. So I was one of the network engineers right at the beginning for Mobineal, which is now Orange. MSEP, hello. Bonjour, ça va? Look at this. It's okay. I'm heading to Fly Tampa's Athens. Lima Golf Alpha Victor. Yep, always. North Europe. Your takeoff from Bari. Where's that? Let's have a look. Bari. Southern Italy. Airport, Bari. What is the ICAO code for Bari? Ah, LIBD. Yep, I got it. Yep. MSEP should pop up over there somewhere. Oh, yeah? Well, that's the point. I need to do some shout-outs, so let me do some shout-outs. So who do we have? We do have... So we got Dryson, who is very much part of our community. And he's also a streamer. There's Dryson. And then we've got Grumpy Gordo. Yeah, that's not the best clip, is it, Dryson? Grumpy Gordo. And I never seem to get a clip of Gordo actually flying. He's always like baseball or something. Charlotte Tea Baggers. And then we got MSAP. We got Snare, but he is on YouTube. So you can find Snare on YouTube by looking for Snare17. And then we got my brother from another mother, Captain Custard, the South African beauty. I feel like I've known Custard for so long. no problem, MSAP. Custard, you do know that that is not an all-terrain vehicle, right? So we should be seeing MSAP popping up. Unless he's too far from me, but I don't think he's that far. Ah, but he's not up there yet. So MSAP actually bought an AMD video card. Which I think is the 6900 or 69,000, I don't know, I can't remember, or 67 maybe. And yeah, so MSAP, we were having a discussion, and guess what, it blew up. Ah, they've dropped in price. But we were talking about the NVIDIA 4000 series, right? But the 3000 series is still high priced. And I was thinking, you know, I mean, AMD, every time I see something in news or whatever, that it's always AMD. AMD is giving NVIDIA a lot of trouble in terms of performance. That, you know, the performance of the AMD is very, very good. So I'm thinking, why do we always focus on NVIDIA? And maybe AMD is also not a bad product to investigate. The 67XT, how much is that for, I wonder? Copy, let's see. What is the price of the 67XT? Let's go to Amazon and find out. I'm not going to show you my Amazon page because you'll see that the kind of crap I look at. So is that the RX, right? Yeah. Wow, 541. And that is 12 gig RAM. And that's from Radeon. Oh, sorry, from Gigabyte. Wow, 500, man. MSI, yeah, they're a little bit more expensive. Asus Tech is a bit more expensive. Oh, here we got one here, an MSI that is £461. I'd rather get my video card dispatched and sold by Amazon. Include installation, £60. £60 to install. I'm in the wrong business, man. So here, is a recent price increase, actually. The price has gone up by 10%. But it's still low. Yeah. I'm thinking I'm looking to get another video card, but and then maybe the video card I'm using here I will set up. So I have another motherboard right behind me, so I might make that into a streaming platform, and then this machine is just going to be for the game, doesn't have to worry about streaming. What's this one? Okay, this is 10 gig for 419. I can get 12 gig over here for £500, just over £500. I know what DLSS is, okay? I've tried it on Sim Update 10. I can definitely see the benefit. What is the equivalent for AMD? Is it that Fidelity FX? You will continue using TAA and then play around with the Fidelity FX, is that correct? What does that mean, anti-lag option? I just saw that somewhere. There we go. Let me just translate this English. There we go. Okay, AMD Fidelity FX. No stuttering, no tearing. Monitors with AMD FreeSync. Oh, hold on. Sorry about that, Mrs. Gadget walked in the room. Anti-lag option to tick. Why would you not just have anti-lag by default? Why? So I don't understand that. In the AMD software, it has anti-lag. I don't have to pay extra for anti-lag, right? It's part of the software, yes? Okay, right, because I'd hate to buy a product and okay, you're gonna have lag with this option, but if you want no lag, you can buy the anti-lag package. I mean, that doesn't make sense. What is this company? Is this company like Darty? It's like Darty or what? Or like PC. Yeah, PC World. Or we call it Currys here. PC World is now part of Currys. Okay, we're heading towards Greece now, right in front of us. MSEP should be in the air, but I don't see anyone right now. Which leads me to believe that the server is messing around. So let's have a look. Where is our, there's our descent. There's our top of descent right there. And I've seen MSEP stream with his video card and it's a very nice result. Amazon Egypt, maybe £700. £3,000, not Egyptian pounds, right? British pounds for a 3080. Is that from Amazon, dispatched by Amazon, or dispatched by a third party? That can't be Amazon stock, or if it is, then maybe they just got some really high duty in Egypt for import. I keep hearing, I hear a slight clipping of my sound. Don't know why. Are you in the air, MSEP? I'm seeing no nameplates at all. Oh, there's one. There's some nameplates. So MSEP should appear. I see these two in front of me, Champy 1922 and a Cessna 152. We've got about 150 nautical miles, I think. Yeah, to top of descent. I wonder when they're going to be pushing a an update for this Phoenix. It's far from perfect. I am so looking forward to the A380. So looking forward to it.
Hey! Be a man! Be a man! Do the right thing!
So there's Corfu. So this is the island of Corfu down there, with Corfu from Fly Tampa right there as well. So Fly Tampa right there. Right there. ...128 nautical miles to top a drop. Shame the printer doesn't work either. And did you see on the A380 they have implemented this as well. This also works, so you can put your seat up and forward and back, and then the okay, this works. But they've also implemented the window opening in the A380 as well. It looks so nice. It looks so nice. In fact, let's just play that fly-by-wire video for those who haven't seen it. Where was it? There. So those who haven't seen the fly-by-wire video, let's have a look. There, look at that. So there's a bit of look at the wear and tear on the knobs there. There's the two stickers that say in-op, but that's an Easter egg. Look at it. It's a shame they didn't show the outside. Yeah, so that's all implemented now. Ah. And there was the spelling mistake there. I think it looks very, very nice. Really looking forward to flying that. It looks beautiful. Here we go, just over about 100 miles till the topper drop. And let's bring that down. What was wrong with your control? I set up individual control profiles for all my aircraft. That's not MSAP in an F-18, sniped dog. Okay, okay. Let's see. So there's my top of descent coming in there. And now it goes into reverse thrust. Okay. Oh, update ARAC. Okay. Okay, what are we doing? We are 60 nautical miles from top of descent. Let's start setting up. So let's go to our Perth. Next phase, there we are. And let's pull in our Meta arrival. There we are, 1009, and temperature is 30. There we go. Okay, and we have 120 at 9, 120 at 9. Okay, and let's pull in the chart. Okay, our approach is Zulu EGN 29, right? Oh, what runway were we flying into? Yep, 21 left. Zulu, there we are. Okay. Overlay. So, we got that. Decision height is 503. And we have to be at 1900. Okay. And that's our approach going in. So we are coming in from here. And then we're going to follow that approach in. 503. And we are good. That's where we are currently. So right there. And then we will come into our star at Nimes and then fly the arrival circuit. Is there any MSAT yet? Is he up in the air? Whoa, I got an escort right there. Look at that. Who's escorting me? Brilliant. Who is that? Hey, Snipe Dog, is that you in an F-18? I think I did see you. I saw your nameplate earlier. How you doing? I had no idea I was being followed. Brilliant. There he is, right on my wing there. Awesome. Oh, I've lost him. Let's get back. There he is. There he is, right off my wing. Is he coming around? There he is. Very cool, very cool. Whoa, whoa. Top of descent almost. There we are. 1900. There we are. Okay, we can start our descent. Here we go. And we started our descent. And there is my fighter escort. Samurai, hey, how are you doing, sir? You all right? We've got a fighter escort. We've started our descent into Athens. So I don't know if the fighter jet's going to land in Athens as well. And we've got MSEP somewhere, but I don't see him. He's not up in the air yet or what? Oh, he's behind Swift Biscuit. But there's our fighter jet. Can we zoom into the cockpit there? Let's have a look. Oh, no. Okay, that's not a problem. We will go drone. Let's go drone. And there is... Keep still! And there is... my fighter jet pilot escort. Keep still, dude! There he is! Let's get right in there. Nah, he's overcorrecting. Oh, we can look right into the cockpit there. There he is.
Our fighter jet escort.
Okay. Let's see where we are. Okay, 29,000 feet. Our descent profile looks good. Looks good. Speed is also okay. So we've got MSAP over by Corfu. But he's still not, he's not coming up on the old nameplate yet. So we're heading towards VOR DDM. And actually, let's have a look at something here. There we are, DDM. And then EGN, and then into our final approach. Come forward a little bit, Snipe, so I can see you out of this window. There he goes, poking the nose. There he is. And this is when the passengers go, oh my God! What's happening? What's happening? We're gonna get shot down. What are the Americans doing so far from home? There he is. It's not easy. It's not easy to maintain speed. And I'm going to slow down in a minute because, yeah. Okay, we're going to head towards EGN now. Let's see, did he keep up with me? There he is. Wow, what a shot. Hold on, that's a screenshot, that is. Wow, that is a screenshot. Got it, copy. That is a screenshot. Hey. Here we are, done. That is a gorgeous shot, that was. Yusuf. Yusuf. Salaamu Alaikum. Thank you for the follow. Welcome aboard. I just saw your Nomad stream. I just saw your Nomad stream. I'm watching him while I'm watching me. Welcome aboard. You catch us. We are on our descent and heading down to Athens, Fly Tampa, with a fighter escort. Right there. Our descent profile is good. 17,000 feet. We are heading over EGM right now. Here we go. Beautiful scenery around here. Beautiful scenery. Here we are, 15,000 feet. He's doing well to stay on course, huh, the fighter pilot there. That is Snipe. That is Snipe Dog on phone. Doing very well. Doing very, very well. Thank you, thank you. Although I do prefer the 737 myself. It is hard snipe. It is. I appreciate those constant control movements all the time. Yeah, Yusuf, I prefer the 737, to be fair. I just think the 737 is just such a gorgeous looking plane. Feet. We have a transition level of 9,000 feet. Here we are. We should also have everything in our rad nav page. There we are. Yes, we are. 111.1. Everything is all set. Our performance page is also set. So what I will do is I will move that flight plan over there and we'll go to performance here. And yeah, that just helps me better. And there we are. So we're going to be flying over the top of Athens. So we're going to fly over the top of Athens. That's Athens right there. And we're going to fly across and then come back on ourselves to come in on runway 21 left. Let's bring the fighter escort into view as well. There he is. Yeah, I think the 737 looks good in a lot of liveries. It's just a very good looking plane. Although I think when the Phoenix comes out with the sharklets, maybe that's also going to make it look quite nice. Okay, 10,000 feet. Let's landing lights are on, seatbelts on, and signs on. There we go. Everything else here is okay. So we're flying over the top of Athens. There's Athens. There's the main terminal down there. And we're coming in on 21 left, which is that one there. Yep. Okay, 9,500. Let's pop the landing systems on. There we have the, there's Athens below us. I tell you, Sniper's doing a great job. I should employ him to be my fighter escort for all the flights. Hey, we'll do a flight over Iraq next. Here we are. Okay, let's concentrate on this. So we go 1009 is our Q&A today. We will just check that, refresh 1009. There we are, 1009. Perfect. And that's also good. Our descent profile is still okay. Above 7, yes, above 3,000. We're going to probably end up dropping a lot quicker, I think. There we are. Okay. 6-7. Where is our, that's our approach mode right there. Should be kicking in, I think. So let's start dropping. Come on, come on. Oh, we are low apparently. That's okay. Let's see what happens. Could start to drop again. Oh, there's Samurai Frog in front of me. He's also in a top cap, a tomcat. There we go. And now we started our descent again, and we're going to really drop. Here comes the yo-yo, and it's going to take us down quite quickly. This should change. This page should change to our approach, activate approach mode phase, right about there. If it doesn't, we will activate it ourselves, but it should change. There we are. And it is activated. Okay. Dropping. And he's still on us. Wow, Snipe, dude, you are the boss, man. Okay, let's go flaps one. And bring that speed down. We are good. Whoa, localizer, there we are. Let's capture that. And approach. We are a little bit high. Little bit high. But it will catch it. It will catch it. No problem. Okay. Drop the gear. Slow us down. There we are. Okay, we are good. Let's set flaps two. And there we are. Let's just get the APU ready. All right. Flaps three. Spoilers armed. No. There we go. Spoilers armed. And we'll go flaps four. Here we are. We are exiting right. And he's still on us. Okay, I have the plane.
1,000.
Okay, let's fly it. Of course you can, Batman, but I'm not going to fly it after this. I've got a little bit of some stuff to do, but I will definitely do a flight that you suggest, of course. But I like to keep my flights 500. Like 2 hours tops.
100 above.
There we go.
Flight slow.
Yeah, nothing wrong with my glide slope.
Glide slope. Glide slope.
100.
Whoa, 50. What? That's a long landing, that is.
40.
That is a really long 30. Landing.
20. Retard. 5.
Whoa, what's going on with my, what's going on here? That is weird. Hello? That was strange. Well, did I forget the auto brake? Ah, damn. Oh, I forgot the auto brake. Oh, the landing was great, but yeah, forgot the auto brake. Couldn't slow down. Oh, but that's okay. All the passengers survived. We're okay. Ah. That was horrible. That was horrible. Pilot error. That was pilot error. I forgot the old auto brake there. I actually was going to do that, but then I focused on something else and then I didn't do it. I do remember thinking about it. Okay, welcome to Athens. We are on the runway. It was a sucky landing. Very sketchy. Samurai. Oh, I had like two fighter jets. Where did Snipe go? Is he back in the air? Because I did see him sort of go through the grass. Right, let's there's Snipe, Samurai. MSEP supposed to be around here somewhere, but there we are. Let's go to the top. They can go off. That can go on. That can go on. I feel I have to do another flight today. I have to do another flight, redeem myself. Yeah, that's what I have to do. I have to redeem myself. And I have to do it in the Phoenix again. Oh, I hate the Phoenix. Okay, let's turn here. Or maybe we'll do it in the 7-3. Okay, let's find one of these guys. I have a problem flying in Pakistan, man. I tell you, it crashes in that one location. I've tried that flight before and it crashes for me every time I come up to Lahore. And I'm not the only one. Many people have said exactly the same thing. It happens to some, it doesn't happen to others. I don't understand why. There's a problem with the mesh in that area. For me at least. Not just me, there are other people as well. Okay. It's not actually over Lahore. It's near sort of Lahore Faisalabad. There is a certain area. Okay, let's do this. And stop. We should be good there. Yeah, wow, look at that. Spot on. All right, parking brake is on. Do we have APU? We do. So APU bleed can come on. There we are. And we can then shut down. Engines flaps can go up. Spoilers back. There we are. And we can shut off the engines. Engine 2 off. Engine 1 off. We can call in ground services and D-board. GPU, chocks, there we are. Ground power is available. APU bleed can go off, and that can go off. Lights are off. Seat belts off, and signs can stay on. There we are. And do we have the jetway coming in? Yes, we do. This is Fly Tampa. Beautiful, beautiful airport. There we are. And deboarding is take or deplaning, I think they call it. Commencing. Nav. 3 off, 2 off, and 1 off. There we are. There we go. All right. Thank you, everyone. That brings it. I'm going to call it on this one. I've got a little bit of some stuff to do, but I am going to redeem myself and we will do a stream later on today. Snipe dog, man. Much. It was a terrible landing. MSF, it was a terrible landing. I forgot to do my auto brake. It just carried on going. Yeah, I've never forgot to do my auto brakes before. Snipe dog, you are the boss, man. Yeah, if I ever needed a fighter escort, you're the guy I'm going to be calling on. Thank you so much, Snipe dog. I think I saw you go right across the grass. Yeah, mate. Ah, you're most welcome. You're most welcome. Thank you. But I am going to do another flight later on today. In the Phoenix again, because I have to redeem myself. And, yeah. We'll do that again. I normally do textbook landings. But I don't know. I was just lazy and not paying attention today. But yeah. Cool. Where is he? Do I hear a fighter jet around me? Is there a fighter jet around me somewhere? No. So there's Snipe Dog over there. MSEP, where is MSEP? I don't see. Oh, there's MSEP. How far are you, MSEP? Where are you flying over right now? But anyway, look at this airport. Isn't it nice? It is a very nice airport. This is Fly Tampa. I think one of their best. Oh, you're not at top of drop yet. Okay. Yeah, Fly Tampa is a beautiful airport. But yeah. All right, guys. I'm going to catch you all on the next one. Today, all right, and we'll take it from there. Thank you, everyone. Snipe Dog, thanks for the follow, and wow, thanks for the follow, and thanks for the follow. Yeah, brilliant. Yeah, Yusuf, thank you so much for the follow. Batman, MSAP, Gordo, Solar Hawk, Captain Custard, Snare, everyone, thank you for joining us. Dino, who went to bed earlier. Thank you, Dino. I will catch you all. Grand Wazoo. Thank you. Uni301. Thanks a lot for the follow. And I will catch you all on the next one, which is going to be today. And we will redeem. I will redeem myself. Maybe we'll do a fight out of the US. Somewhere in the US. Somewhere in scenic. Or maybe Asia. Asia is waking up as well. All right, so yeah, I will catch you all on the next one. All right, guys, bye-bye. Stay safe, peace be with you all, and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.